Hey friends, it's Reverend Ben, and if you're like me and you've been watching the news this week, you're a little frustrated. So I did a search in Worship Web for a chalice lighting with the word frustration in it, and I found one. It plays with the phrase "we gather together." I really liked it. It's by Reverend Libby Stoddard. We gather together. Familiar words to many of us. We, called here not by name, not by special invitation, but we who are here, who, walking by the door, come in. I would say walking or rolling by the door, come in. Who come anonymously, burdened and born by our visions, yearnings, despairs, solitudes. So that's we. Gather, called here not by law, not by outer compulsion, but by inward necessity do we come, alone or with others, casual yet intent, drawing in, drawing toward, drawing near. Together. This is the hardest, Libby Stoddard says. This is the most difficult thing for within and without this building and this room, and I would say this video, we irk, frustrate, and anger each other at least as often as we lend or give support. Together is a place. Together is a way. Together is a focus, an acknowledgement that we who gather are seekers and are equal in our seeking. Reverend Libby Stoddard, thank you. This Sunday's worship service is going to be about the democratic process, and I'm really looking forward to that. Many of you know we just passed the Article 2 revisions. Most of you know that it was an 80% vote, that 20% of our beloveds at the General Assembly voted against the Article 2 revisions. We've just had a presidential debate that seems like satisfied nobody. This practice we have called democracy is hard. It's not easy. And yet it is precious. It is worth defending. And I'll talk more about that on Sunday with our guest, Ashley McKnight Taylor from the Pinellas County Voting Registrar's Office. Please submit your announcements to this video by Monday noon. This week's appreciation goes once again to the communications team. Round of applause for the comms team. Check out the new website if you haven't yet, uusaintpete.org. Write to them and let them know what you love about it. I would like to see 10 emails coming to the communications team. That's communications@uusaintpete.org. Say, here's one thing I love about the new website. In the news this week, Unitarian Universalists in Louisiana are suing against the mandatory Ten Commandments being posted in public schools. You've probably seen this in the news. My Unitarian Universalists in Louisiana probably don't mind religious education in schools. What they mind is it being mandatory and it being just Christian. Our folks here at UU St. Pete are trying to determine how we want to respond to this. So let me or Janae know if you're interested in helping formulate that response. Donate your shoes, please. Our goal is to get 100 pairs of shoes, and we want to thank all 63 of you who left 63 pairs of shoes. So we're on our way to 100, and you can put them right near the Keurig in the front office. Please volunteer to live stream as well. That's fun. I'll teach you, or someone else will teach you how to do it. You get to participate in worship service. You even can, if you're doing a reading or participating in the bell ringers, you can like go down and do that and then come back and finish the live stream. Let me know if you want to do that. Now this week on Wednesday night, we will have fellowship on tap at Three Daughters Brewing. I won't be able to make it, but I know that a lot of you will be there, and I love fellowship on tap. Then when you come on Sunday, please bring some snack and some food items for the kids attending their summer camp at the St. Pete Youth Farm. We're going to have a special collection, and we're requesting cookies, ramen noodles, mac and cheese, fruit cups, ice pops to be frozen, don't bring them frozen, peanut butter crackers, chips, pretzels, microwave popcorn, peanut butter, jelly, bread, drink mixes, all of those things and more. If you can bring them, that would be wonderful. And the subsequent Sunday, July 24th, we're having New Member Sunday. That's exciting. You might have seen the photo just now of Sandra Moss signing the book. There will be guest speakers, Lisa Pineda, who is an indigenous leader from the Taíno Nation, and Reverend Bob Murphy, who some of you remember used to be a member here, talking about weather-related things and hopefully a little bit about indigenous permaculture. My office hours are Monday, Thursday, and Friday from 10 to 3. I would love to talk to you then, but if you're not free then, write me and we'll figure out a different time. The office is closed this Thursday and Friday in observance of the July 4th holiday. Cheyenne is still on vacation until July 11th, and I will be on vacation July 17th through 31st. Now, you remember that when we extinguish this chalice, we put the electric flame out, but that's when we ignite the flame in ourselves. And that flame in us is an unquenchable fire. Let's keep it going until we see one another again. I know things can be frustrated. I know several of you who have a lot going on in your personal lives, illness, breakups, heartache, pain, housing issues, economic concerns. But you're not alone. And I hope you remember that. Blessings, friends.